Hi there, this is your friend Birendra Deer. My real motive of life is to always strive to seek to find the various ways and means by which we can bring prosperity to our life. And when I say prosperity, prosperity is an attitude of mind, a moral power which manifests outwardly in the form of joys and happiness. Moral virtues are the foundation and support of prosperity, as they are the soul of greatness. To find moral principle is to have found prosperity, excellence and truth. The principle of prosperity is sustained by energy, economy, integrity, system, sympathy, sincerity, impartiality and self-reliance. It was explained by James Allen. And these essential ingredients of prosperity can really bring one from darkness to light, from sorrow to enjoyment, from suffering to prosperity, opulence and abundance in life. Beloved friends, the last point of this eight pillars what James Allen described, self-reliance, is really the secret of success. When we talk about self-reliance, we mean looking to oneself only for strength and support by standing upon principles which are fixed and invincible, and not relying upon outward things which at any moment may be snatched away. And one of the greatest saints of Concord, Ralph Waldo Emerson, composed a short poem on self-reliance. Henceforth, please God, for if I have forego the yokes of man's opinion, I shall be light-hearted as bird and live with God. I find him in the bot of my heart, I hear his voice continually therein. The little needle always knows the north, the little bird remembereth his note. The wise shear within me never earns, I never taught it what it teaches me, I only follow when I act aright. Beloved friends, if you want to be successful in life, you must develop tremendous self-belief and self-confidence within your power of personality. Because the Lord was very kind at the time of your birth, who blessed you with intelligence, the power of your mind to control and direct towards attainment of anything on this planet Earth. Just by you have to streamline your thought process. You have to cultivate a habit to harbor noble thoughts and great thoughts and purity and thoughts. The thoughts of supremacy, the thought of greatness, the thought of attaining all great which can really be helpful to you, and simultaneously it can be spreading the light of pleasure, happiness, enlightenment in the every heart, soul and mind of the people. And for this, you must learn this fundamentals of greatness, that is self-reliance. But for self-reliance and self-belief and capacity of applied faith, you can never be great in life. Remember what the great Buddha, the great teacher, said to his disciples, those who, either now or after I am dead, shall be a lamp unto themselves, relying upon themselves only and not relying upon any external help, but holding fast to the truth as their lamp and seeking their salvation in the truth alone, shall not look for assistance to anyone beside themselves. It is in this among my disciples who shall reach the very topmost heights, but they must be willing to learn. Beloved friends, look into these words. The repeated insistence on the necessity for relying upon one's self alone, coupled with the final exhortation to the eagerness to learn, is the wisest utterance on self-reliance that ever known to the mankind. In it, the great teacher Lord Buddha comprehends that perfect balance between self-trust and humility which the man of truth must acquire. Beloved friends, self-trust is the essence of heroism. All great men are self-reliant, and we should use them as teachers and examples, and not as props and perambulators. A great man comes who learns, leans upon none. A great man comes who leans upon none, but stands alone in the solitary dignity of truth, and straightway the world begins to lean upon him, begins to make him an excuse for his spiritual indolence and a destructive self-abasement. Better than cradling our vices in the strength of the great, we newly light our virtues at their luminous lamp. If we rely upon the light of another, darkness will overtake us. But if we rely upon our own light, we have but to keep it burning. We may both draw light from another and communicate it, but to think it sufficient while our own lamp is rusting in neglect is shortly to find ourselves abandoned in darkness. Our own inner light is a light which never fails us. Beloved friends, believe in yourself. Have tremendous faith in your own capability and also in the infinite supreme intelligence. As the great Emerson says, trust thyself. Every heart vibrates to that iron string. Throughout the ages, men have so far leaned and do still lean upon external maxims instead of standing upon their own native simplicity and original dignity. The few who have had the courage to do so and stand upon themselves have been singled out and elevated as hero. And he is indeed the true hero who has the hardihood of let his nature speak for itself, who has a strong mettle which enables him to stand upon his own intrinsic worth. And on the contrary, the timid, the apologistic man who seems almost afraid to leave, who fears that he will do so something not in approval by the society, by the system, and will subject himself to ridicule, criticism, is not a full man. He imitates others and have no independent action. He needs that self-reliance which will compel him to fall back on his own initiative and so become a new example instead of the slavish follower of old ones. As for ridicule, he who is hurt by it is no man. The shafts of mockery and sarcasm cannot pierce the strong armor of the self-reliant man. They cannot reach the invincible citadel of his honest heart to sting or wound it. The sharp arrows of irony may rain upon him, but he laughs as they are deflected by the strong breastplate of his confidence and fall harmless about him. Believe yourself. Be a man of trust. Keep your head, and never anything can harm you. Sooner or later, you will turn for guidance to the self-reliant man. And while the best minds do not make a prop of him, they respect and value his work and worth, and recognize his place among the gods that have gone before. Believe in yourself. Be a man of trust. Keep your head when the world doubt you. As the great Kipling said, if you can keep your head when all about lose theirs and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance to your doubting too. Beloved friends, really believe in this philosophy and you can really make miracles. You can become so great that all will come to you and respect you and really love you so much. Look at this peacock. It is spreading its wings. Thank you very much. Be a self-reliant man, man of self-belief and self-confidence. God is your guide. You are great. Thank you very much for watching this video.